West Ascension Consolidated Drainage District is called to order for July 9th, 2014. Mr. Kent can do the implication.
Dear Lord, again, we want to thank you for all the good things you've given us in Ascension Parish, especially the good people here. We'd like to ask you to try to continue the recent good weather we've had and protect us from all the storm in this storm season. We'd also like to ask you to have in our prayers, to listen to our prayers, all the families that have lost loved ones this recent week. We ask that you keep those in mind and comfort those families. And that once these meetings are over tonight, that everyone gets home safely. We ask all these things in your name. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right, roll call, everyone is present. Anybody in the audience like to speak, please just sign up. Item number three. Accept the minutes for June 5th. Minutes is approved. Master drainage plan. Mr. O'Neill, I know we're still playing around with
still working on
bodies and everybody.
Right.
We know, I mean, we had one party.
Most of our drainage is going to be through the farmers' fields, and they've already started planting and grinding, so that will probably be not until after grinding season before we can really make some headway there.
All right. Item number five. Is a smoke bin, Barcelona Drive. Mr. George.
As I told y'all the last meeting we had, we felt pretty good about what we had so far with us digging the front out and everything, and we went ahead and blew out almost all of the culverts on that street. And I told you that Craig and I had walked the street, and we had found one problem where there was a fairly good-sized gap between two culverts where trash, dirt, and everything else was getting in there. In fact, the other day when we looked at it, it looked to me like they were actually using it as a garbage can. So we have dug down. We put a band on that. We covered it back up, sealed it. We covered it with dirt. Tomorrow we're going to go ahead and cover it up with some riprap limestone and fill in the rest of that area. I feel very confident that we have taken care of that problem on Barcelona. Their yards now in heavy rains are no wetter than mine. So I think we did a lot of work on that, and I'm proud of them guys. That's what I have on that.
Okay. All right. No other. Once again, we had the big rain and had the big flood and everything. It's just that the first thousand, I wouldn't say the first thousand, but the second house, they got some covers in there, and I know there's small covers, and that's one thing we just need to look at on the normal flow of rain, because I know when they have an overflow, they have by at least 6 to 7 inches of rain stays in the front, that front part right there.
We have been watching it, Mr. Chairman, and Craig does not live far from there at all, and he periodically checks it after rain.
Yeah.
So we feel like we did a pretty good, save a lot of money doing it, what we did, okay? We'll watch it. We'll continue to watch it.
Yeah, because okay. I mean, I have the two landowners at the front. Every time they have a rain, their front yard is flooded out. And we all know they're in the flood zone. It's just mm-hmm. as fast as we can get.
One of them got a really low yard, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
All right. Good. Item number six, St. James Assumption Drainage Update.
Okay. There is a letter of agreement, professional services. I talked with Jody. At the meeting that we all attended, they went back and said they were going to look at doing some more survey, an environmental site visit, participate in the agency and stakeholder coordination and permit drawing preparation for it. They think they have that identified now. The cost to do all that is going to be right at $22,000, $21,900. What I'd like to see us do is back one second. I've asked him to go ahead and check with the levy district and also Ascension Parish to see if they would participate in this. What I would like to see us do is make a motion and amend the budget to whatever we have to do to at least pay half of this, cover half of this, until we get an answer back from those, and that way I don't have to let this hang anymore. When I start getting an answer from St. James about the next meeting, we'll know that we have that cost.
The total is $22,000, you want a half of 22?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Go ahead, I just want to ask a question.
I was just gonna make that motion that we would pay up to $11,000, depending upon who else jumps in to move this forward and try to get some of drainage to assist St. James, because that's the only way we're gonna get some drainage.
Yeah, I think you're correct.
I have a question, no problem with the motion. Question, George?
Yes.
We already authorized for 19, we already, that been taken. Remember, we authorized 19.
That's correct.
It's a different charge from.
Correct, these, when we, if you remember, when we had the meeting, we, they said there was some, we determined that there were some additional things that needed to be done. And we asked them to come up with a cost on what it would cost to do the rest of this study, okay? That's what this is, all right?
Okay, we good.
That's what they helped with.
I second that motion.
Yeah.
Any objection? Nope. Motion passed for the amount of $11,000. Not to exceed $11,000. All right. Number seven, Grand Bayou Drainage. This is, George, we must, yeah. This is, I don't think they call it Grand Bayou.
Yes, it is.
That's what they call it?
It's called, I was gonna call it one of the Grand Bayou Canals, yeah.
Okay. We have a landowner, I thought Mr. Haran would be here. I know we took up some pictures and everything. He put a big cover and he put a pump on it. My question is to legal, and who make an answer. Do we have to get a Corps of Engineer permit, or they have to prove anything for him to put a cover, block it off and put a pump on it? I mean, it's a major drainage from my house and in my community. And I'm just concerned if something happened and nobody go up there and open the gate or turn on the tractor, run out of gas, who's responsible? Someone's house get flooded.
Well, I mean, he put the pump in the culvert in, but I mean, I don't know if he had to get a permit or not. I guess somebody who's in the engineering department would have to tell us that.
Well, that is my question. And I'm asking the administration can look into it and find out what's the proper procedure we need to go through with the Corps of Engineer, our drainage department.
Parish President may be able to understand, answer this, but to my understanding, before any of this work should have been proceeded, a Corps permit should have been gotten. Now, we didn't do this work. We didn't, we took no part in it whatsoever. In fact, I drove up on it and finally it was being done, okay? I mean, Parish President may be able to answer this better than I can, but as far as I'm concerned, before we would have done that work, we would have put our hands on a Corps permit to do that work, all right? Now, I have some additional issues. You know, there's a berm now. They dug it out. They took the dirt. They put a berm on the side with the dirt. So there's a lot of things there that are in question. But again, the landowner did everything himself. We took part in none of that whatsoever. In fact, we're probably not even going to cut the berm.
Well,
okay. This is an issue, but I mean, that's all I can tell you on.
Well, and once again,
we're not the regulatory agency there. That's the court. Anybody can do what they want on their own property. They put themselves in that jeopardy. And of course, anything that you would do according to the law, it would cause someone else to flood and cause them to have flooding that they didn't have before. That property owner would certainly be one in jeopardy. Am I correct?
If that's what caused it, absolutely.
Shouldn't we, if we were going to have to get Corps permits in order to do the work, and we didn't, but somebody else did it, shouldn't we inquire to the Corps about whether a permit should be gotten? I would like to see us.
If you want to send a letter inquiring about the work from the drainage board?
Yeah.
That's
what I'm saying is we're not the regulatory
agency. We agree. I have no problem with him doing it. I have no problem.
Willing, if you're willing to send a letter for them to inquire into the
Yeah, I mean, just.
That's what you're asking?
Right.
I think that's certainly.
That would be appropriate, because we have to establish that the people in that area, that whatever they're doing is proper, that the people in the area is protected. That's all.
And like I said, the property owners in jeopardy, if anyone else would be caught with flood from work that he did, he would certainly be held responsible.
Yeah, and I have no problem with what he did or anything. It just makes sure.
That's all we wanted, all I want to know is just to have something acknowledging that they is aware of it, who's responsible for it. If anything happened, we can put it on the book as the record.
Because in the past, I know we've had to fix the sins of the past on things that were done without our blessing.
Do you have pictures of that work going on? Did y'all take pictures?
Yeah, I think we took some pictures. I think between Craig and I think between Craig and I, we have some pictures. We don't have them with us, but we have some.
Yeah, just send them.
Send in the report, you can send in the pictures.
That's all, that's all we can do.
Legal will get with us next week, maybe, and we can.
Yeah, I mean, we can, whatever, find out.
Just send them a note.
Yeah, because I have no idea. I ain't honest.
That's all. Okay.
I mean, you can go tomorrow and take pictures. The damage is done, so.
Okay, all right. Moving on to item number 8. Westside DPW, West Central Drainage Building update.
Okay, I spoke with Mike yesterday. We exchanged emails yesterday. The revised set of drawings are supposed to be done by the end of this week, for a review of the final drawings and specs, to follow within a week after the review is complete. And we're waiting for the chief engineer to get the site-related drawings complete, and then it should be able to put a packet together and go out for bids.
Okay.
So we're getting awful close.
Okay, all right. Then item, Mr. Shakespeare, you have anything before we go to Mr. George Verdigna, because it might be long.
Well, the only thing I know, George, we've had some water issues in A-Ben and St. Jude subdivision, and I'd like to just get on next month's agenda, maybe get a little report on what or if or can we do some things to alleviate some of the problems, and if we can't, we just need to, you know, let people know that too. And because I know we have been looking into a number of different things of how to alleviate the problems, or where we can, and some things that can't be done. So,
well, I was going to give you a little bit of something under my report, but I'll go ahead and give it to you now. Our ditches are fairly clean.
Mm-hmm.
We did get a little trash buildup from that rain event. Craig's crew is now at this time working on cleaning some culverts at the railroad track. And as soon as we get through with that, we're going to clean the big culvert that flows by Everett underneath the under Highway 70 by Sunshine mm-hmm. Lounge and John Deere. We're going on that next. There's a little bit of debris in there that washed up. That's the only problem we have in our parish in that area. Okay, if we get that clear, we're good now, really. Can we have another 13-inch rain in 10 hours? Now we can't do that, mm-hmm. but we're in pretty good shape. Okay, and might as well go right on
into
it.
Yeah, Judge, continue with your report.
Might as well go right on into it. That was one of my main things I was going to tell you. We're working steadily on trying to get that done. We're heavy into the grass cutting of all the ditches. We're making around. Everyone needs to understand. Okay, I don't know how else to explain it, but it takes us a little over 3 weeks to make the round. We start out in Lemonville, we come all the way up the River Road, we go to Modest, we leave Modest, we go through the Brule, we come out to Brule. We're cutting roads and ditches in all these places. When we get through the Brule, we come up, we catch Highway 1, Highway 308, we take the ditches to Bayou Napoleon and all those ditches, we're cutting them, and then we're starting all over again. And these guys are not stopping. They're non-stop right now during this time. The little bit of rain, you can sit out in your yard and watch the grass come up. So everybody's got to bear with us and understand we're coming around. We're not quitting, okay? That's really big with me, because you get calls just constantly for it.
I give them to Josh. That's what I say. Where y'all located at? M.O. That's where y'all next.
That's it. I don't have anything else, Mr. Chairman. That's good.
Mr.
You can see it growing.
Yep.
Mr. Craig Anderson, you have any?
George said what I wanted to say, but the grass growing, that's about it.
All right.
He said it all.
Okay. All right. Next meeting, item number 10, next date, time, and meeting. August 7th. 5:15. Might change that time, though. 5 o'clock, Ken? 5:50. Item number 11.
Move to adjourn.
Meeting adjourned.